Honorable Union Minister, respected Sri Narendra Singh Tomarji, Honorable Union Minister MOS Sri Kailash Chaudhary Ji, Honorable Minister for Agriculture, Government of Kerala, Sri Prasad Ji, respected Secretary, Government of India Agriculture, Sri Sanjay Kumar Agarwal Ji, Dr. Palla Rajeshwar Reddy, the Chairman, Telangana State Raitu Bandhu Samiti, Madam Shobha Thakur Ji, Joint Secretary, Government of India, Sri Mahapatra Ji, Dr. Mahapatra Ji, Director ICAR, our Chief Secretary, Sri Somesh Kumar Ji, our Special Chief Secretary, Sri Ramakrishna Rao Garu, our Secretary and APC, Sri Raghunandan Rao Garu, Honorable MLAs who are present here, Sri Manohar Reddy Garu, Sri Gandra Venkatramana Reddy Garu, Government Whip and MLA Sri Balakasuman Garu, Sri Surendar MLA Garu, former Special CS Sri Nagireddy Garu, our Vice Chancellors Dr. Pavin Rao Garu, Dr. Nirja Prasad Garu, dignitaries present in the summit, friends from media, ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon to all of you. It's our pleasure and we are privileged that the National Summit is being organized and the state of Telangana is hosting it here in the beautiful city and most happening city, that's Hyderabad. We are thankful to Government of India for having taken a decision to organize this summit here in Hyderabad. As you all know, our state, the Telangana, that has been carved out from the composite state of Andhra Pradesh on 2nd June of 2014, being 29th state at that time, and now it is 28th state. It has got a geographical area of almost 1.12 lakh square kilometers. सब हमने हमारे चीफ मिनिस्टर जी हमारे मंत्रीगण और हमारे अधिकारीगण पिछले दो तीन महीनों में दिल्ली जाना पड़ा भारत सरकार की ओर से मंत्री जी पीयूष जी प्रोक्योरमेंट मिनिस्टर और ऑफिशियल्स को मिलना पड़ा मिलते रहे उन लोगों ने कन्वर्सेशन में ये बात की अरे भाई आप क्या जादू की कि इतने फसल आ गए आपके पास के हम नहीं ले सक रहे आज हिंदुस्तान में तो हम बोले साहब जादू नहीं की हमारे केसीआर साहब एक नए तरीके से एक नया विजन से जो है सो मेहनत की 7 साल की मेहनत की जो है सो वो आज ये पैदावार है तो कहीं कोई लड़का अच्छा पढ़ता है कोई आदमी अच्छा काम करता है कोई किसान अच्छा पैदावार करता है कोई साइंटिस्ट अच्छा इनोवेट करता है डिस्कवर करता है और कोई लीडर अच्छी राजनीति से आवाम को ज़्यादा फायदा करता है कोई अच्छा सोशल वर्क करता है हर किसी को हम इंकरेज करते हैं शबाश बेटा और आगे चलो जब तेलंगाना पंजाब से भी ज़्यादा पैदावार कही तो तेलंगाना को सपोर्ट करना है भारत सरकार की ओर से कैलाश जी मेरे बाजू में इससे पहले बोल रहे थे अरे भाई आप कैसा जादू की क्या जादू की इतना पैदावार आ रहा आपके पास तो आप तमाम लोग भारत सरकार की ओर से हमको दुआएँ देना चाहिए यहाँ के फार्मर्स को दुआएं देना चाहिए आप ही की कहावत थी कि क्रॉप डाइवर्सिफिकेशन करो नीड ऑफ द आवर उसको जहन में रख के भारत सरकार बोलने से और पूछने से पहले से ही यहाँ पे तेलंगाना सरकार ये क्रॉप डाइवर्सिफिकेशन के वास्ते हमने बहुत ही स्कीम्स इंट्रोड्यूस की आपके सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम्स को जुड़ाते हुए और हम अलग करते हुए फार्मर्स को मोटिवेट करते आए हैं कि नीड ऑफ द आवर क्या है कंटेम्पररी पीरियड में हिंदुस्तान में क्या हालात है ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड में क्या हालात है कि हालात को जुड़ाने के वास्ते हम कैसे क्रॉप्स कल्टीवेट करें इसका काम चल रहा ऑलरेडी तो शुरू में ही मैं आपको बताना मुनासिब समझ रहा था इसलिए मैं आपको हिंदी में दो चार बात बताने के लिए कोशिश की आपकी उतनी फंसी हिंदी नहीं हमारी हमारी तो जबान उर्दू से मिलके है यहाँ की हैदराबाद उर्दू हैदराबाद हिंदी Thank you, sir. So, the visionary steps and the innovative decisions and the initiatives that the Honorable Chief Minister of Telangana, Sri KCR, had taken, like initiatives like 24 hours free and quality power supply to the farmers. Aur iske baad, the one and only unique scheme in the entire world, nowhere in the world, It's called Raitu Bandhu, giving 10,000 rupees per acre to all the farmers, to the entire cultivable area of agriculture, which has now amounted to including this season. Our Special Chief Secretary Ramakrishna Rao Garu has given me just now the figure that farmers of Telangana have been given during the last 7 seasons an amount of rupees 50,675.63 lakhs. 50,000 crores of rupees have been pumped into the accounts of the farmers of the state, which has directly helped them in bringing out huge producers in the agriculture. The irrigation facility and the extension systems have enormously triggered for the growth of agriculture in the state of Telangana over the last 7 years. Since the formation of the state of Telangana, it has gone up. The cultivable area has gone up from 42% to now it's almost that was 122 lakh acres hitherto. Now it is 2 crores 3 lakh acres now. So that is the progressive increase in the cultivable area of the state. This has resulted into the production. The production that has gone up from 68 lakh metric tons that was registered in 2014 and 15, and now it is 259.2 lakhs, 2 crores 59 lakh metric tons in 2021. Similarly, the increase in horticulture area could be seen. There is an increase of 23% in the horticultural area increase. We have increase in mango, we have increase in red chilli, turmeric, vegetables and other major crops. The enhanced irrigation facility has resulted in increase of our paddy enormously. And we have surpassed the paddy production of Punjab, which has recorded almost 5 to 6 decades first in the country. Now we have surpassed Punjab, sir. That is where we need appreciation of Government of India. We are not expected to have a cursing view on the farmers of the state of Telangana. So we should have appreciation. You may always ask us to go for diversification, and we are ready. Therefore, having felt the need for crop diversification, we are now educating the farmers, driving the farmers to go for oil seeds, pulses, vegetables, fruits and so on. As it was enumerated, it was illustrated by our Chief Secretary Somesh Kumarji, it was also shown in the documentation that the technical committee, high level committee that was constituted by Government of India, it has visited Telangana in a span of 1 year twice, and it has recommended, saying that as on the date of their visit, they concluded that 25 districts out of 33 are most suitable for cultivating oil palm in the state of Telangana. And after their recommendation, 3-4 districts have also added because of the vegetation, because of the irrigation potential that has been spreading. So except Hyderabad metropolitan city, I don't think there will be any area that will be remaining which is not suitable for cultivation of oil palm in the state of Telangana. That is the beautiful ecosystem that is most favorable for cultivating oil palm in the state of Telangana. So, in the light of these aspects, there are certain issues which we would like to request Government of India to take into cognizance. So, considering the potentiality in Telangana for oil palm with increased irrigation facility and owing to its importance under crop diversification from paddy, maize, etc., state government has laid thrust on oil palm area expansion. With the continuous and diligent efforts of the state government, Government of India notified an additional potential area of 4.36 lakh hectares, which is equivalent to 90 lakh acres. 5 years action plan under NMEUP. The Government of India has launched a new centrally sponsored scheme, namely National Mission on Edible Oil Palm, Oils and Oil Palm, from 21-22 to 25-26, with a total outlay of rupees 11,040 crores, and out of which Government of India's share is 8,844 crores. The mission aims at covering an additional 6.5 lakh hectares under oil palm in the country by the 25-26. Whereas the Telangana government intends to cover an area of 12 lakh hectares, that is 30 lakh acres, as it was said by our Chief Secretary just before, under oil palm from 21-22 to 25-26, with an outlay of rupees 13,968 crores in a mission mode in view of the huge potential. Jitna aap target kiye usse zyada karne ke liye hum tayar hain. Area is suitable. We are intending to take out. Therefore, in view of tremendous potential for oil palm cultivation in the state, it is requested that the following issues be taken into consideration. That is, number one, approval of action plan to cover 30 lakh acres. Secondly, provision of an amount of rupees 7,170 crores towards central share for the above area. Revision of indicative cost and norms under micro irrigation for oil palm. Considering the actual field requirement and increase in raw material cost in the recent past, the unit cost of micro irrigation components for oil palm crop is being enhanced to 53,465 per hectare, which is resulting in additional burden on the state government. Hence, it is requested to enhance the indicative cost on installation of drip irrigation from rupees 27,304 per hectare to 50,000 to 55,000 per hectare for oil palm crop under PMKSY. Similarly, we request for extending micro irrigation assistance for the entire plantation area taken up by the farmer, as there is no such restriction on extending cultivation assistance for plantations. Relaxation of 7 years locking period for availing micro irrigation assistance for oil palm farmers exclusively. Considering micro irrigation component of oil palm under NMEO as a special case instead of under PMKSY PDMC. Enhancing assistance on inputs and intercrop. While welcoming the decision of Government of India in enhancing the assistance on plant material, it is also requested to enhance the assistance on inputs and intercrops from the existing 5,250 per hectare per year, keeping in view the cost of fertilizers and PP chemicals. Minimum guarantee price. This is very important, sir. The farmers of Telangana opine that the viability gap payment is not in their favor. Hence, there is a need for provision of minimum guarantee price of rupees 15,000 per metric ton for oil palm fresh fruit bunches. Assistance on border plantation also is requested. The farmer can raise an additional income through border crops like sandalwood, bamboo, teak, etc. Hence, border crops should be encouraged for oil palm plantations under MMEOP so as to make it full-fledged mission. So these components and elements may kindly be taken into consideration while examining the subject, and we assure you that, sir, Telangana will be the first state in achieving the target that is posed by Government of India, and we will not be inferior to anyone. We will be far, far superior to many states in the country because of our pro-farmer policies that are being taken up and adapted in the state, and also the ecological and irrigation potential that is favorable to the crops. Therefore, you may kindly take into consideration all these aspects and encourage the state of Telangana in a wide crop diversification, which will not only help the state of Telangana and its farmers and its economy, it will also add to the national economy. Thank you. Jai Bharat, Jai Telangana.